What is going on, guys? This is Ben here. So you guys know in yesterday's video, I trophy pushed on the main account, the Benton one. We got up to 57. I forget what exactly what it was, but then I won a match today. And then I decided, you know what? I need to trophy push on my level 12 account. It was sitting around 4,000 trophies. I need to get up there for wars. My card levels are decently high. Like, the battle deck that I'm rocking right here is with the P.E.K.K.A. It's basically P.E.K.K.A. NATO, and then it has, like, the minor control aspects. With the ladder getting moved to, like, 3-minute overtimes over 4,000 trophies, it's really, really helpful. This is really, really solid. And I noticed, like, so if you're struggling, like, around the 4,000 to, like, 4,400 trophy range, what I notice is so many players are running the bait battle decks. Like, there are so many goblin barrels, there are so many minion hordes, there is so many, like, just, like, bait out your things that cannot deal splash damage. I don't know, like, bait out the log. Just, it's crazy. So the executioner literally shuts down all of those, and with the poison. So if you have the ability to and you're struggling with facing the bait battle decks, I would say maybe use the tornado more, maybe throw in a log and stuff like that, because, like, the executioner is the reason why I'm winning all these magic. So I have won 14 matches in a row here, over 4,000. So it started back, let's see, our last loss. So our last loss was 3 days ago. So that wasn't even a ladder match. That was from the clan war. As you can see, it was draft. So yeah, earlier today we are at one. Well, technically I'm at 15, but if we do just ladder matches, because then I won a I don't even know what that is. Some clan, we won the clan war attack. Sorry, I couldn't think of it. But yeah, just ladder matches, we are at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. We're at 13 wins right now. So we're gonna be hoping to get 15. That's gonna be the goal. We're on the push. Like I said, I just started pushing today. So maybe we can try and get to 4,600 soon. That's the main goal, just to get more clan war cards for our clan, because we are in Legendary League now. Again, you can see we're back up to 3,100. Shout out to clan for winning the last war there, taking first place. Nice. So other than that though, let's get into the battles. Showed you guys the battle deck, showed you guys that we're on a nice, technically 14 win streak right now, but just ladder matches 13. So we'll see what up. And we are facing a level 13. Oh my gosh, here. Let's get it. So, I don't want to be the first to drop my card levels. It depends what card levels he really has. So he's going with a deep goblin barrel. Still drag that to the king tower. It's only level 10. Okay. So I'm telling you guys, people just play the bait Battlex. I don't know what is it. Like, majority of the Battlex I've rocked, like, that I've been playing against that got me up to here have been bait Battlex. It's crazy. And the executioner and everything else just shuts him down. Oh my gosh, he is going in. He wants that chip damage as much as he can. So he might be playing, he might have the Inferno Tower. If he does, my P.E.K.K.A. drop is a little nasty. It's not the best. Normally I don't like to drop it this early, but I didn't really have a good option. I didn't feel like I did, actually. So what we're gonna do is go in with the miner, and I'm actually gonna poison. We're probably gonna see some sort of, there it is, the goblin. The goblin's there chilling. Sadly, my poison actually shifted on me one tile to the other side, like my finger slipped or something. It happens more often than you would think. So we're gonna go in here with the, he's going on the front side this time. So at least his bait isn't too strong. It's mainly like I just need to start minor chipping and minor cycling him down to keep up with this, because I can defend his stuff fine. Like, my executioner is gonna be great. He's really just persistent on always dropping on the bridge though, so that's kind of annoying for sure. But as long as I keep my minor cycle there with the poison going, we'll be in a pretty decent spot. So he's gonna log. I'm actually gonna throw down an executioner here and just wait till I have 7 elixir. Actually, no, I'll go with the miner right now. Like, his goblin barrel is only level 10 too, so it's not the biggest worry in the world. Sadly, I gave him some pretty good value with that Valkyrie. Finally did hit the double elixir. He's going deep with that goblin barrel though. You can always see how deep it's gonna go. That's as far back as I could put my log. So missing one of them was not the end of the world. Probably see the princess drop too, right? So he's trying to get as much chip as he can. Oh my gosh. Doesn't have the log. Does have the Valkyrie though. Keep that in mind. He's mixing it up. He's doing the normal goblin barrels and everything else too. So I'll probably get some value poison here. If I can get that mega minion to the tower, we'll be in an okay spot. So he's starting to cycle rockets and everything. He's getting pretty desperate. So I'm gonna just try and throw down a P.E.K.K.A. in the back and try and push through here. Get some sort of chip damage. I know he has the Tesla. We know he has the log. We know he has the Valkyrie. We know he has, like, all of that stuff there. So, throw the guards over here. I'm not gonna log this time. See if we can finally get that P.E.K.K.A. through. We get something through. Thank you. So, all of his bait. I thought the reason why I tried to go in there is after he just dropped the rocket on my tower, you knew like that was our best opportunity to go in because he finally just wasted 6 elixir for nothing. And then try and push through. I think he misplayed it a little bit at the end there, throwing down like the Goblin Gang how he did. But hey, that is 14 in a row. And that was versus a level 13. Yes, his card levels, I mean, some of them were level 12. It wasn't anything really max, so it wasn't that scary. But man, that's 14 wins in a row. You can see it looks really sweet too. Like some of the epics and the P.E.K.K.A. matches really, really, really nicely with our emblem. So nice, that's 14 in a row. Can we make it 15 here? Let's see, we're going up against the level 12 here. Goblin. Telling you guys, it's bait all the time. So rock those wizards, rock those executioners, throw in those poisons, whatever you have, the log. Anything if you're dealing with, if you feel like you're facing bait all the time. That's what you gotta go with. Okay, technically we don't know if it's always it's gonna be bait this match, but we'll have to wait and see. So we're going up against the furnace. It could be the Royal Giant. It could be Elite Barbarians. Those are all good candidates to be in this style of battle deck. It still could be the Hog Rider too. But no, it seems as though it's just original log bait. I would have liked to activate my King Tower actually there. I didn't notice that was my bet at least. Hey, it doesn't even really matter. Probably the better one that I logged there because it would have done way more damage. But we know he has... This is a straight bait, for real. With the mirror in there. And then also, he might have the rocket too, so I have to be very careful where I put my executioner. Okay, I'm gonna throw the P.E.K.K.A. in the back. Sit back for now. We know he has bats. He might have minion horde. Still could have like elite barbarians. The mini P.E.K.K.A. I'm not too scared of. We got the guards for that, so. Not bad. We'll counter that pretty nicely. This is where the executioner is going to have to go in. Gonna get some value off those bats. Now we will probably see the Goblin Gang, right? Spend where? Oh, the value. Nice, executioner. That's how you do it. Sadly, our P.E.K.K.A. is almost dead though. So go with the miner. Force him to at least we're getting some chip damage. Trying to beat him at his own game, really. But I don't have the lock. And he does have a Goblin Barrel. But we're about to hit double elixir, so there's negatives and there's positives right now. Like the negatives are I can't deal with that at the moment because I wasted my lock, which I'm gonna have to do. I haven't seen a rocket though or many big spells, even though he probably does have one. Just wants to get rid of that. Oh my gosh. Still got a little bit of chip damage in there. So this is kind of scary, man. It really, really is. So he's going with the furnaces. I'll go in with the poison. This time I'm gonna save my log for sure. Come on. Get through there. He's really pressing really hard here, so I think we're doing okay. He did that right into the poison. He did get a little bit of chip damage in there, sadly, he got it. Come on, Miner, we got him though. Let's go, dude. That was a tough match. The bait is real, I'm telling you. I don't know what it is about 4,000. I'm probably ordered over 4,500 now. Close to 45. I'm just literally every match, it seems like it's log bait battle decks. So for those of you who are struggling around this range, just put in the anti-bait cards and you might be pretty good. Now I do realize like there's other battle decks gonna be going around, but the reason why I'm running the P.E.K.K.A. one is I know Elite Barbarians are a thing around here. I know a lot of people run the Royal Giant, not the Royal Giant. Yeah, I guess it is the Royal Giant. I thought I mixed up the card name. No, the Royal Giant. And then there's also the Golems around here. So I feel like this has the best matchups for so many things. And with the new overtimes, you can just start to cycle down. Now, if you don't have all the cards, that's another thing. If you don't have them all high level, that's another thing too. But I'm just saying, try. I don't know, man. I just feel like there's so many bait battle decks around here. And that is 15 in a row. Let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 16 with the Clan War battle. So we'll do one more match here, see if we can get to 4,500. Maybe tomorrow, if I win here, I'll try and continue the streak. I don't know, you guys gotta definitely like that if you wanna see it. The battle deck is strong here, though. Depending on where the miner was, I was gonna drag that to my King Tower, but let's drink the Hawk there anyways. Take him out. There we go. Do I go with mine here? I mean, I might as well. I don't have anything else to cycle, so we get to see more what he has. Another Valkyrie. A lot of Valkyries are around here though too. Do I dare? Yes, I do. I'll drop the guards now, show them. I mean, he still could have something heavy like a P.E.K.K.A. It's not out of the realm of possibilities. As long as he hopefully doesn't have a rocket. If he has a rocket here, it's gonna hurt. But with how heavy his battle deck is already, I don't think he would be rocking it right now. We'll have to wait and see. And I am gonna throw down an aggressive P.E.K.K.A. here. Try and get some value. So at least he missed with his fireball. I don't know if you guys saw that. Well, you can now. The executioner didn't take. Oh, that was a big mistake. Now we have a huge counter push. Took care of barbarians with minimal damage. He used a fireball. I mean, our executioner sadly isn't hitting the tower, but that is fine. The P.E.K.K.A. is still alive and healthy, taking care of all that, getting so much value here. Miner is still taking the damage for the P.E.K.K.A.s. Wow, that's a little bit where the card levels come into play, like the P.E.K.K.A. being level 8 and everything. Wow, we almost just 3-crowned him on that push. That's pretty crazy. I could just literally miner cycle and log him and everything. I think I'm gonna do that. But I have to be careful not to be like incredibly aggressive and get automatically 3-crown. Like he still could have like the P.E.K.K.A. or something in here. We never really know. As long as I play defense, cycle around to my next poison, throw it on the miner on the other side, we'll be in a good spot. Like this is kind of what I was a little bit scared of too. But our King Tower is activated, so it's not gonna be the end of the world. And he didn't even get a tower yet. So, we'll throw on the poison first. I'm gonna miner into the middle so I can log the same side too. Push anything back, and then that is gonna be the victory. So, good game. Throw up the princess emote too. These are the only emotes I really have. I have some of the goblin ones, and that's about it. So we are up to 16 wins in a row. Well on our way up to 4,600. And this is just straight ladder matches, so I hope you guys enjoyed the video. So many 3-crowns, so many bait battle decks. Let me know if you want me to try and continue the streak in tomorrow's race, see if we can get 20 wins in a row. Pretty awesome feeling. I mean, yes, our card levels are fairly high, so it's not that big of a feat. Normally, most of the times when I do trophy push, it's always on the main account, so this kind of gets pushed behind, but it's kind of cool to like not drop a match on the push back up to what I maybe should be at. Because like my highest trophies ever on this account was only over 4,600, so we're getting there close. But other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. For those of you struggling with all the bait battle decks in between 4,000 and 4,500, it's crazy. Like, I didn't expect it to be that bad. Throw in your anti-bait stuff like the executioners, tornadoes, wizards, whatever. Witches even solid now too. Logs for sure. But other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. Stay tuned for more awesome videos. Let me know how your ladder trophy is pushing and your clan wars too. And also, I forgot to mention, a special event tomorrow. Just need to get 20 crowns. That's, if it's a free entry for this, basically get a free 100 gems if you just get 20 crowns. It doesn't matter how much you lose, it's just literally counting crowns. But thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys later. Oh, one more thing. You see the haircut too? Forgot to mention that. I literally had to take another shower recently when I got home, so if the hair is a little messed up, I don't put gel in it or anything yet. But thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys later.